Hello everyone, my name is Meenakshi and I'm doing a video series on the Indian Contract Act 1872. In two of my previous videos, I discussed about the background of Indian Contract Act and also the difference between a contract and an agreement. If you haven't watched my previous videos, I will leave a link to that in the description box below, so you can click on the link and go to the playlist and check all my other videos related to Indian Contract Act. Today, we will be discussing the difference between an offer and a counter-offer. Let's begin. Offer or proposal is defined under Section 2A of the Indian Contract Act. It defines when one person signifies his willingness to do or to abstain from doing anything with a view to obtain assent of the other to such act or abstainance, it is said to be a proposal. So, what is a proposal? It is mainly one person saying something to the other with a view to obtaining his assent. If I want to supply raw materials to you, I would go to you and tell you that I am willing to supply raw materials to you every month and I am expecting 10,000 rupees for that supply. So in this case, I am making an offer to you. Why I am making the offer? Because I want your acceptance to that. That you also agree to pay 10,000 rupees for the raw materials that I will supply. So when an offer is made, when I am making you an offer, you have two options. You can either accept the offer as a whole or you can reject it. If you are rejecting my offer, if you say that I am not in need of any sort of raw materials, so I am not willing to enter into any contract with you, it would be rejected. That means the offer that I made to you is rejected. That means it would result into no contract. No contract would exist between you and me. But in case you decide to accept the offer, you have two options. You can either accept the offer as a whole. That means I told you I'm willing to supply raw materials to you every single month for 10,000 rupees. You have accepted the offer as a whole. You have accepted that you would be receiving it every single month. You would be paying me 10,000 rupees for those raw materials. In case you are accepting the offer as a whole or in total as it was made to you, it would lead to formation of a contract. But you may put certain other conditions to the offer. For example, when I told you that I am expecting 10,000 rupees in return of the raw materials, you may tell me that you can only pay 8,000 rupees for the raw materials, but otherwise you are fine to accept it every single month. So in that case, you are not accepting the offer, neither are you rejecting the offer. What you are doing is, you are making a counter offer to me. That means you are making a counter offer that you are willing to pay only 8,000 rupees to me for the raw materials that I will supply. So in this case, I will have the option of again accepting or rejecting the offer. That means you become the offerer, I become the offering in case of counter offer. Our positions would change. Now, I again have two options, either to accept or to reject. In case I reject the counter offer and I tell you I am not going to accept 8,000 rupees for the raw materials as they are very expensive, I need 10,000 rupees only. In case I reject your offer, it would not lead to formation of any sort of contract between us. But in case I accept your proposal, if I agree that, okay, fine, I am going to accept 8,000 rupees and supply raw materials to you, in that case, it will result to formation of a contract. So when an offer is made, you have two options, either to accept or to reject. If you are rejecting, it would lead to formation of no contract, no agreement. If you accept, you can either accept it as a whole or you can put certain other conditions. If you are accepting as a whole, it would lead to formation of a valid contract. And if you are putting certain other conditions to it, it would result to formation of a counter offer. Our position would change. From an offerer, I would become the offeree. From an offeree, you would become the offerer. Now it would depend on me whether I want to accept or reject your offer. So this is the main difference between an offer and a counter offer. I hope this topic is clear. In the upcoming classes, we will discuss more about the essential elements that we need for formation of a valid contract. Until then, bye-bye.